Hey guys, Ivan here and welcome to another video. In this video, we're gonna do a prediction for the Arnold Classic 2023. This photo that you're looking right here is from last year Arnold Classic, and it seems like three of the guys from the last year's top six might be in the top six this year again. Two of them, most likely, Samson Dauda and William Bonac, and maybe even Justin Rodriguez. Now let's take a look at the list of this year's Arnold Classic. And so as you can see, we have William Bonac, Sean Clarida, Samson Dauda, Kamal Elgargni, Big Ramy, Andrew Jacked, Patrick Moore, Justin Rodriguez, Nick Walker, and Akeem Williams. So it's definitely not as deep of a lineup as Mr. Olympia was. I mean, there was 36 freaking competitors. This one is definitely much smaller. There are only 10 guys here, but all of these guys can beat each other pretty much, and we have no idea what's really gonna happen. But I have an idea, kind of, what might happen based on all of the updates and all of the things that I know, and I've been doing videos throughout this entire prep. I heard a lot of stuff, I've seen a lot of stuff, so I kind of have an idea, but really I could be completely wrong. Though I'll try not to be biased at all. Like, I do have some physiques that I prefer more than the others, but I'll try to look at it from the judges' perspective, and I'll just tell you what I think is gonna be the outcome, not what I want to be the outcome. So I highlighted the top six guys. As you can see, that's everybody except for Kamal Elgargni, Patrick Moore, Justin Rodriguez, and Akeem Williams. I would have highlighted the top five, but I'm not so sure about the top five. I'm pretty sure these guys are gonna make the top six. Sixth spot, though, might be changed, but I have my idea what's gonna be the top six. So let's start from the end. Let's start with the 10th place, last place, and in my opinion, that's gonna be Kamal Elgargni. So I've seen a couple of photos, some updates, and in them he's actually finally starting to show some signs of aging. I mean, you may have noticed some of them in the past few years. He's over 50 after all, I think he's 51 right now, and he's still a very good competitor. He's still the very top of the 212, but this is open division we're talking about. Last year he wasn't able to beat Akeem Williams at the Tampa Pro, and Akeem wasn't really on at that show. I think he's gonna be much more on this time around, and I don't have him in my top 6. And since that Tampa Pro, I think Kamal showed some more signs of aging. I think his legs are starting to downsize, I think his back is showing some atrophy, and at this point, at his age, he's not gonna, you know, get worse over the course of 10 years and compete until he's 60. No, it's gonna happen in like a year or two, like it happened with Dexter Jackson, for example, you may have noticed that. So I think this is the year when Kamal really starts to fade and potentially stops competing, so I have him in my last place. I could be wrong, maybe he brings some crazy conditioning and beats some guys who are not really on, but right now, at this point, I have him placing last. Now, in 9th spot, I have Patrick Moore. Now, Patrick Moore, he might place higher because he did show a lot of his physique during this prep. Like, he showed that he's bringing some pretty good conditioning, and he's known for having really good shape, and it seems like shape is being awarded more these days. And also, this is the Arnold Classic, as you guys know, Arnold prefers those kind of physiques, so maybe this will go well for him. But, you know, considering the other guys are so much bigger than him, that is the reason why I can't have him higher. Even Kamal Elgargni might be bigger pound for pound than Patrick Moore, but I think he's showing, like, again, he's melting a little bit in some areas, and Patrick is still very young, he's still looking very fresh. If he brings great conditioning, he might place higher than I'm expecting him to, but as for right now, I have him in my 9th. Now, we're coming to 8th place, and obviously it's between Akeem Williams and Justin Rodriguez. And even though Justin is a great bodybuilder, if you ask me, I mean, he's a really big guy, and when he's in shape, when he's conditioned, when he peaks, his physique doesn't really show the asymmetry, the lack of shape, and that kind of stuff that he shows when he's off. Like, he has a little bit bigger obliques, a little bit bigger waistline, his legs kind of have a weird shape to them, they look like he stuffed them with Sintel or something like that. There are some body parts of his that don't really look that good, but when he's peeled, when he is shredded, when he is super hard, he does tend to look much more aesthetic. So even though I think he's a great bodybuilder, I just can't really have him above Akeem Williams. Akeem Williams was 6th at the Mr. Olympia in 2020, and even though Justin has a much better back than Akeem, I think Akeem is just even bigger and he has some really freaky body parts, and with conditioning I think he's more consistent. He doesn't really always bring great conditioning. I think he brought it once that year in 2020. Two shows he did, he brought it that year and that was it. But I think if he brings it, it looks like he's bringing it. I think he's a better bodybuilder than Justin Rodriguez. With those horse legs, like he has crazy, crazy thickness in those freaking quads, especially from the side. Also really big, really massive chest, crazy bicep peaks. If he brings okay conditioning, I don't know, man. I wasn't sure if he's gonna be out of my top 6 or actually 6th. Because in my eyes, I could potentially see him edging out Big Ramy this year at this show. And yeah, I have Big Ramy in my 6th. Now, from what I saw so far from Big Ramy, I'm not really seeing that he's that much changed. I mean, his coach, Chad Nichols, is kind of saying like that his back is a little bit improved, like 20%, and his triceps as well, and that his dents in the quads are gone. I don't know about that. I kind of have a hard time believing that. So yeah, I know that he didn't peak properly, and this time around they might change that. But even if he peaks better, if he is not watery at all, if he is full, with his injuries, with his atrophy everywhere on his physique, I just can't see him beating the top 5 guys. I can see him beating the other 5 guys, but I just don't believe he's gonna place higher than 6th. I don't see him beating none of these guys that I have in my top 6 along with him. So in my 5th spot, I have William Bonek. That's right, William Bonek, yeah, I know he won the Arnold Classic twice, and that he also was kind of off at the Mr. Olympia, and that he is coached by Chad Nichols. So if he brings it this time around, if he is really on, he can be pretty dangerous. But I kind of believed in this for a while now, and it seems like the old William Bonek is not gonna come back. I mean, I don't know, I might be wrong. I mean, last year at the Arnold Classic, he was really good, and Boston Pro also, he had some gyno, but I mean, I thought it was close at Boston Pro between him and Justin Rodriguez. So I think William Bonek's best days are probably in the past. I could be wrong with that. I mean, he could win the show. Again, the entire top six, I would say. The entire top six right here, including Big Ramy, can win the show. If Big Ramy fixes everything that was wrong about him last year, and if, for example, William Bonek brings his absolute best, then sure, they might win the show, but I don't think that's the more likely scenario. So in my 4th, I have Sean Clarida. Now, I know that he's a 212 guy, not a 212 guy, he's like 180 guy. You know, that's his usual competition weight. Right now, at 1 week out, he's around 190, but once he depletes, once he dehydrates, I think he's gonna be like in the mid 180s, which is like really light compared to, for example, I don't know, Akeem Williams, who's gonna be competing at like, I'm guessing 270s, probably. And I think Justin also competed around 270. I mean, Big Ramy only is 310 pounds right now, so he's gonna compete at around 300. So he's gonna be like over 100 pounds heavier than Sean Clarida. But man, I think Sean Clarida is just so complete that the judges will be able to ignore his height to a certain level. Now, we saw him beat guys like Regan Grimes and Sergio Oliva, but these are not the top echelon of bodybuilders in the world right now. These guys in Arnold Classic, however, are. So I can see him beating some of these freaking mass monsters. I can see him beating Akeem Williams because Akeem Williams really doesn't have a back. I can see him beating Justin Rodriguez because he has problems with shape. I can see him beating Big Ramy because Big Ramy has a ton of problems. And because of that completeness that Sean has, and because I know he's gonna peak perfectly, as he always does, and I know that he's gonna be super conditioned, and he looks very, very fresh, and with that bubbly kind of look, with all the 3D, with the hardness that he has, the fullness and everything, I just have him ahead of all of these big guys, and William Bonek too, because William Bonek is also like a former 212 guy. He's not as small as Sean, but he does have some flaws, and Sean, really, the only flaw that Sean clearly has is his height, and that's it. And in comparison against William Bonek, it can be overlooked because he's not that much shorter than William. And he is much smaller than Big Ramy, but again, Big Ramy, too many problems, man. So I have Sean Clarida in my fourth. Now, as far as the third place, this might sound kind of disappointing to him because Samson was third last year at the Arnold Classic, but it was a much weaker lineup. This year, in third place, I have Samson Dauda. So if Samson ends up in third, it doesn't mean that he stagnated from last year in terms of placing, no. If he beats William Bonek, that he wasn't able to beat last year, if he beats Big Ramy, that he wasn't able to beat at the Mr. Olympia, and if he proves that he is better than the 212 Mr. Olympia champion, I think overall that's a great success. So I think Samson Dauda is gonna make a progress in that sense. He's gonna beat some of the guys that he wasn't able to beat before. So in my opinion, a bronze medal for him again this year. Unfortunately, the same spot like last year, but the lineup is deeper. I mean, what would you expect? I mean, the prize money is $300,000. So of course, it's gonna be tougher to win this show or to place higher than last year. Can Samson do it? As I said, anybody in this top 6 can do it. But the question is, how can Samson Dauda win this show? Well, in order to win this show, he needs to beat Nick Walker. Now, based on all of the updates, it seems like both him and Nick are bringing something pretty similar. I think both of them are gonna be a little bit better, but they're probably gonna be similar. I can't expect Nick to fail with Peak Week. Let's be honest, I mean, when did Nick Walker mess up his Peak Week? When was he off on stage? Was he ever? Once? I don't think so. I don't think he was ever completely off. And I think with his structure, with his shape, if he was off, at least a little bit, it would show. So he was never off, really, and I'm expecting him to be on as much as Samson at this Arnold Classic. And if that is the case, I have Nick Walker ahead of Samson Dauda. And so, as you can notice, we are left with two guys, Nick Walker and Andrew Jacked. Now, who's gonna be the winner of this show? The thing is, Nick Walker, I have him ahead of Samson, for sure. But Andrew Jacked can be sixth. Can be sixth or first. Or second, third, fourth, or fifth also. So I think it all depends on what Andrew Jacked really brings. And based on what I'm hearing, and based on all of the factors, the fact that he is working with one of the best coaches in the world right now, Chris Aceto, and that he has a trainer that, as you can see on the social media, on Instagram and YouTube, this guy, Chris Psycho Lewis, is forcing Andrew Jacked really freaking hard. I'm pretty sure Andrew Jacked is hating his training, but he is really pushing it. And I heard some rumors that he really improved. And I have a feeling that this is gonna be the 100% of Andrew Jacked that everybody was talking about last year when he showed up at Texas looking absolutely insane. So, in my opinion, I think Andrew Jacked is gonna win this show. I think so. I think Nick Walker is gonna be second. Now, you might be thinking the reason why I have Andrew Jacked winning is because this is Arnold's show, and Arnold Schwarzenegger likes the classic looking, the more aesthetic looking guys with beautiful shape, and that's gonna make the judges judge the show differently. And so if that was my logic, based on that logic, Samson would place probably second ahead of Nick Walker, right? But that's not my logic, guys. I don't think that's gonna happen. I think it might mean a little bit, a tiny little bit, but I think in the end, the best bodybuilder overall is gonna win the show. And I don't think there are politics in these high-level shows. I mean, up until 2-3 years before, everybody was thinking that the reason why Big Ramy can't win the Mr. Olympia is because he is not American, he is not a great ambassador for the sport, his English is not perfect. And he won the Mr. Olympia twice. Dan Hardy won this year. Hardy doesn't speak English at all. So you guys can see the best bodybuilder wins the show. The best combination of everything. And I don't think Andrew Jacked is all shape, only shape. I think he's a massive bodybuilder. He has some really freaky body parts. I think his back is gonna look better. I think his hamstrings are gonna look better. I think his conditioning is gonna be better. And if he just overall peaks better, brings better shape, comes in fuller, a little bit improved, I think it's gonna be hard to deny that bodybuilder. And I don't think, I don't see Nick Walker's crazy muscularity and conditioning are gonna be enough to take over 100% of Andrew Jacked. That's why I have Andrew winning this show. We'll see, I might be totally off. He might be 6th. I don't think he's gonna be lower than that, but he might be 6th, he might win. I personally think he's gonna win this show. I think Nick is gonna be 2nd, Samson 3rd, Sean Clarida 4th, William Bonac 5th, and a big Rami 6th. And then Akeem Williams 7th, Justin Rodriguez 8th, 9th is Patrick Moore, and last spot is Kamaru Al-Gargani. That's my prediction, guys. That's my top 10. That's my entire lineup prediction. If you guys disagree with me, you can tell me down below. If you guys enjoy this video, you can like it. If you have a comment, please leave it down below. And if you enjoy watching this kind of bodybuilding content, if you like my channel, please subscribe to it, guys. It will mean a lot to me. Thank you so much for watching. All the best, guys, and bye-bye.